Next one is the BCD adder. Okay. BCD addition is different from the binary addition. Okay. So in BCD, we take values from 0 to 9 only. After that, whatever value you have, that value will be splitted into two parts. So suppose you are having 10 will be represented separately. 1 will be represented 0001 and 0 will be represented as 0000. You will split the values. But 0 to 9 you will take like this. 0 means 4 zeros, 9 means 1001. After this, whatever value you have, that value will be taken in this way. You will split number of digits. Suppose you have a number like this. Each independent digit will be separately coded. So that's why we are calling as binary coded decimal. Each decimal value will be coded into binary. So this will be split into three parts. 5 means 0101, 3 means 0011, 4 means 0100. So for 534, BCD value is this. Okay. So representing numbers in BCD is in this manner. And addition also, in the addition also, suppose you want to add 5 and 6, for example. You want to add 5 and 6 in BCD. Then first you have to take this number. 5 is nothing but 0101, 6 means nothing but 0110. You will take these two numbers. Add in normal way. In binary addition, how you will do this operation? In the same way you do it. So 1, this is 1, 1 plus 1, 0, this is 1. Finally, what the number you got? 1011. But 1011 is not there in the BCD. BCD values are from 4 zeros to 1001. This is 0, this is 9. In between, whatever value you have, that is valid BCD. But we got 1011. 1011 is not there. Okay. So the difference in the BCD and binary, these two are differ by number 6. Okay. Because in binary, if you are taking values in binary, after 1001 you will take 1010, next 1011, next 1100, 1101, 1110, 1111. So that means after 9, how many values you are having? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 values. After this, what you will get? 1. In binary, after this value, after 4 ones, you will get next value 1 4 zeros. 1 means nothing but 0001. 4 zeros. So, but in BCD, 10 will be represented as 0001, 0000. That means this value. So, to get the same value 10 in binary, in BCD, you have to, there is a gap of 6 values are there. To fill that gap, you have to add 6 to this result. If after adding 2 BCD values, if result is less than 9, you should not add anything. But if result is more than 9 you got, you have to supplement that thing. Supplementing means you have to add 6. 6 means 110110. 6 means 110. Now you add this number. 1, 1 plus 1, 0. 1 plus 1, 0, 1. 1 plus 1, 0, 1. Now look at the number. What is the number? I will split this number, 4 bits as one part. And before this, no value is there, so I can place zeros. So this is 1, this is 1. So 5 plus 6 is nothing but 11. 1, 1, 11. So by adding 6, whenever BCD sum is more than 9, then you have to add this 6. Once you add 6, you will get equivalent value. After BCD addition, what value you will get? Equivalent value. To do this particular operation, we require one circuit. Okay. That circuit is nothing but BCD adder circuit. Okay. How to construct this BCD adder? So, whatever operation that is shown to you, this operation we have to do with a circuit. Okay. That circuit is nothing but BCD adder. Okay. To construct BCD adder, first you have to take values, binary values on left side and BCD values on the right side. You have to take a table. After taking table, you have to derive an expression for the carry. Okay. So this BCD adder circuit I will give with two adders, two parallel adders. Okay, so first I will give the circuit. For this particular BCD addition, we have to take a 4-bit adder, because here we are adding, if you, in the earlier example we have 4 bits are taken, that means we require a 4-bit adder. This 4-bit adder IC is 7483. If you take 7483, it will add 4 bits. For this I am connecting total 8 inputs. I am calling this as A0, A1, A2, A3, B0, B1, B2, B3. So once you apply 4 bits, A0, A1, A2, A3, B0, B1, B2, B3. If you apply these two things, this is a simple adder. Simple, what it will do, it will add the bits. So, and it produces some actual outputs, 4 outputs. Okay. So, I am calling this as S0, S1, S2, S3. Okay. If whatever inputs you are applying, if these two inputs, after adding these two inputs, if your result is less than 9, then you can take directly this. You can take directly this. But if result is, after adding two numbers, if result is more than 9, you have to add 6. So for that purpose, I am taking one more 4-bit adder. Okay. Suppose whatever inputs you are applying, with those inputs after addition, if the result is less than 9, whatever outputs you are getting, these outputs only you will take directly. These outputs only will take directly. In the addition, if the result is more than 9, what you have to do? Whatever result you are getting from this adder, for that adder you have to add 6 also. So this result will be added with 6. Okay? 6 means all of you know that 0 11 0. 0 11 0 means in these bits 0 1 1 0. That means this bit as well as this bit, this position, these things I will connect to ground. So now first this MSB position and this LSB position both are zeros. If these values are 1, if I kept these values 1, that indicates that I got result of more than 9. If my result is less than 9, then what I will do, these two bits also should be connected to 0. If result is less than 9, we will not use this, we will not use this part. Only whatever you are getting, that will be added with 0, result we will take same result. Suppose, if result is more than 9, for this result you have to add 6. In that case, these two lines should be connected to 1. So, for that what I will do, I will take this. And depending on activation of these two lines, your operation will depend. So that means whatever result you are getting, that result should be, if result is more than 9, then only we have to give 1 to these two inputs. Okay. For that a formula is there, for that C is equal to K plus S3, S2, S3, S1. S3, S1. Actually, this formula we will get from the table, whatever table. If you take BCD values on left side and binary values, BCD values and binary values on a table, and if you solve that, then you will get expression for this. Okay? So, what I will do, this K is nothing but, after adding these two 4 bits, if carry exists, in some cases you will get carry. If that carry exists, that carry I am calling as K. I am calling that as K. And S3 and S2, these two are nothing but result, MSB position bits of the first adder. So I will take an AND gate. This is producing S3, S2. And I am taking another AND gate which is producing S3, S1. So I will take S3, and S1 means this. So C is nothing but k plus s3 s2 plus s3 s1. Okay, so what I have to do, these things I have to connect to an OR gate, and this output I am connecting to this, and this also consisting of some Cout. Now we will see the result. Okay, we will apply some value, and whether it is doing that particular BCD addition or not, we will verify. Okay, so I am taking some value. I will take simple number 0101, same example I will take. Okay, so now we will see this. 0110 is A value, 0101 is B value. Now we will add these. Once these values comes inside, first I will do the addition. 0110 0101, this is 1 1, 0. So now what is the position? S3 is 1, S2 is 0, S1 is 1, S0 is 1. So now by giving these two values you are getting this. And what is carry here? No carry. No carry is there. No additional bit is there. So that means this K value is 0. This carry value is 0. Now these are holding these bits. Now look into S3 into S2. S3 into S2 means I will put the numbers, this 1, 0, 1, 1. So 1 into 0, this is 0. Next, S3 into S1, this is 1. That means OR gate 0 plus 0 plus 1, result is 1. If this is 1, what value you are getting here? This is connected to 0. And these two are connected to this line. So you are getting 1 1 here, and this line is connected to 0. So what the value you are getting here? Same value, 1 0 1 1. Now here you are getting 0 1 1 0. Here you are getting 1 0 double 1. These two will be added. That means 0 double 1 0 will be added to this. Now 1 0 0 0 1. So now what you will get here? 0 0 0 1, and the C out final bit you will get 1. You will get this number like this. So that means this is doing the BCD addition. So we observed for the case when after adding two bits, if result is more than 9, we observed the final result. We will observe one more case. This is 0 1 0 1 5. I will take 0 0 1 0. 1 0 means 2. Okay, we will see this case, what happens to this case. So A is 0 0 1 0, okay, and B is 0 1 not 1. Now after adding this, 1 1 1 0, what is the result you got? 0 1 1 1. 0 1 1 1 means this value is less than 9, less than 9. So I am getting here 0, 1, 1, 1 I am getting. So S3 into S2, what is the result? 0. S3 into S1, this is also 0. After adding these two, no carry is there. If no carry is there, this is also 0. That means here the value is all zeros. If all zeros plus whatever result we have, 0, 1, 1, 1. So finally you will get 0. 1 1 1. 0 plus any value, same value. So if result is less than 9, same value you are getting here. If result is more than 9, 1 1 0 is added to that result you are getting. So this circuit will work like a BCD adder. Okay, so this expression we got from the table. By taking the table of BCD and binary values, and after solving you will get this. Okay.